Midnight, not a sound on the pavement as the moon lost her memory. She's smiling alone in the lamplight. The withered leaves collected my feet, and the wind begins to moan. Memory, all alone in the moonlight, I can smile at the old days. I was beautiful then. I remember the time I knew what happiness was. Let the memory live again. Every street lamp seems to beat a faint listening warning. Someone mutters and a street lamp flutters, and soon it will be morning. Daylight, I must wait for the sunrise. I must think of a new life, and I mustn't give in when the dawn comes. Tonight will be a memory too, and a new day will begin.
Stage Lunchtime Live Series 2 Episode 1. At the moment it's Episode 1 of 4, but you know, with the things that are going on in the world, who knows how many that will be. Now, speaking of things that are going in the world, this is my one bit of social commentary. I don't know if you've heard this morning, but there is a legitimate poll going on that's going to be contested in the courts. Yes, absolutely. A few weeks ago I put up a poll to see how many people liked pineapple on their pizza, and 15 people did and 9 didn't. Now those 9 people are going to take that decision to the courts. Would you believe it? I mean, what a bunch of wowsers. Honestly, put up with it, put up with it. Pineapple on pizzas is great. Okay, that's enough of my social commentary. What's next? Oh yes, charity. We are performing this series once again for Horsham Matters. They have a new campaign for the food bank this season, which is going to be in more demand than ever. And I'd like you to think about chipping some money into that one during the 4 weeks, if you can. And as a matter of fact, I need to say this, no matter where you are in the country, there are food banks that are requiring assistance. So if you're somewhere else, like Wales, like Marilyn's probably in Wales, Christine is in East Sussex. I've got a friend in Australia even. So Claire, if you want to, you can either put into this one or perhaps support your own local food bank. But they're going to be in great need this winter of all winters. In saying that, tomorrow, ladies and gentlemen, on my own page, Jeff Yerrell at Facebook, I'm going to do a bike ride. It's only half an hour. It's not a big deal. But I'm going to do a bike ride and I'm going to sing some songs while I'm riding because I'm only going to be riding in my conservatory. And that is also going to be for Horsham Matters. And the residual money left over from the concert that we had earlier in the year, which is £100, is going to be the amount to kick that campaign off. So if you'd like to chip into that one, the donations will in fact be all the same from this concert or tomorrow. If you choose to donate, be great. Please mention that it's from the bike ride or from Village Stage concerts, as long as people know where the money's coming from at the other end. So that'd be really good. One more quick thing before we kick off. In some of the memory clips that I've got that I'm going to be showing later on in the morning, there's a bit of a sync problem. So you'll probably notice that some people, even some people who are really famous and very competent, they're singing behind their video, which is pretty clever of them when you think about it. But that's what's happened, I'm afraid. So I hope you enjoy the show this morning. I'm going to kick off with a song that you can all join in. And I know people like Carol Cole and Ray Cole and Christine and Marilyn and Claire and all the people that I know are listening. Oh, Paula's there. Annie's there. Hi, Annie. Yeah, I can see some people watching. So here's a song. Join in. I am just a fool, boy, though my story's seldom told. I've squandered my resistance for a pocket full of mumble, such a promise. All lies and jest, tell the man he's what he wants to hear and disregards the rest. When I left my home and my family, I was no more than a boy in the company of strangers, in the quiet of a railway station, running scared, laying low, seeking out the poor, a corner where the ragged people go, looking for the places only they would know. Your bit. Lila.
Lie, 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 lie
The Boxer. Now, I know that you were singing along with that, and it's going to surprise you. I also could hear you, and I'm going to show you what you sounded like. I expect you all feel very foolish for sounding like that. I don't know who that lady was, but I mean, she had a nice voice. I'm not knocking that, but that's what you sound like when you're singing along. Okay, now a feature for the next 4 weeks is I had some face masks made, and I've sent some to some particular performers who've said that they'll participate in this little quiz. And I'm going to show you a picture of the first one, this week's performer, wearing a Village Stage face mask. And it's not a competition that there are a prize or anything, because I can't afford prizes. However, if you do win and you feel inclined, you can either donate to Just Giving Campaign, Horsham District Food Bank, or you can take me for dinner. That's your choice. But just make a comment, tell me who it is, and we'll see how many people are actually on the ball. Okay, here we go. This week's masked singer. Now, it looks like it's a lady, but you know, people with super long hair during the lockdown, you just don't know, do you? So you tell me who that was, and you can take me for dinner. Next week, there'll be another one. Okay, I'm going to do another couple of songs, after which we're going to get on and share a memory from the summer series. But for now, I've got two songs, and they're both Gordon Lightfoot songs. And this one, oh, there was a frost this morning. Paula all like that. She mentioned that there'd been no frost this year. There was a frost this morning, and it was very pleasant, and it's such a lovely day. So this is a winter song, and it's actually called Song for a Winter's Night. The lamp is burning low upon my table top. The snow is softly falling. The air is still in the silence of my room. I hear your voice softly calling. If I could only have you near to breathe a sigh for you, I would be happy just to hold the hands I love upon this winter's night with you. Shadows overhead, my glass is almost empty. I read again between the lines on every page the words of love you sent me. If I could know within my heart that you dying now, my lamp is growing dim. The and to be once again with you. Song for a Winter's Night. I love that Gordon Lightfoot song. I love the fact that he's expressing himself with music so beautifully about the conditions of the weather and the way he feels about it, and that he misses somebody. And this is another one of his songs, a little bit different. Now, I think it's about having a hangover, actually. I'm on my second cup of coffee, and I still can't face the day. I'm thinking of the lady who got lost along the way. And if I don't stop this trembling now from reaching for the phone, I'll be reaching for the bottle, Lord, before this day is done. I'm on my second cup of coffee, and I still can't face the day. The room was filled with laughter as we danced the night away. But my sleep was filled with dreaming of the wrongs that I had done, and the gentle sweet reminder of a daughter and a son. Sitting alone, my friends have all got home. You never know when they'll come dropping in. Thinking of the girls with their fingers in my coat, too young to understand how love begins. I'm on my second cup of coffee, and I still can't face the dawn. The radio is playing a soft old country song, and if I don't stop this trembling hand from reaching for the phone, I'll be reaching for the bottle, Lord, before the day is done. Sitting alone, my friends have all gone home. They never were around when I needed them. Thinking of the girls with their fingers in my coat, too young to understand how love begins. I'm on my second cup of coffee, and I still can't face the day. I'm thinking of the lady who got lost along the way. And if I don't stop this trembling hand from reaching for the phone, I'll be reaching for the bottle, Lord, before this day is done. And if I don't stop this trembling hand from reaching for the phone, I'll be reaching for the bottle, Lord, before this day is done. I haven't had a hangover for a long, 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 long time, but I remember what it feels like. Okay, now, ladies and gentlemen, a memory. Back in May, in fact, on the 11th of May, I had a young lady performer who really excited me. She was, her performances were so full of fun and energy and interesting social commentary within her songs. And I gave her a really big build-up, a great spectacular build-up. And then when it came to start, she wasn't there. She had a few technical problems. So when she actually did come on, she was a little bit flustered. So if you watch this, there's two clips. There's me opening, and then there's the lovely performer who's afterwards, who I will excite you within this memory. Enjoy. Thing is, most of the requests I'm getting are from people who simply just don't know me. You send a friend request, and then you say hello. I could delete it now, and you would never know. You clearly had a look deep into my Facebook, but you don't know me. But still I press confirm, and there's a little gap until I see your post, and it's so full of things I don't want to look at. I'm just another friend that you drive round the bend, but you don't know me. But I've seen my mistake, and now it's too late. You filled my page with tragic songs of sorrow,
and I can't stand the sound, so I simply scroll down until I find the link that says unfollow. I should have learned by now to find the very best. I need to check out all my Facebook friend requests. But when I look at you, I know there's just a few who really know me. But when I look at you, I know there's just a few who really know me. And I thank you for that too. Thank you for getting to know me on Lunchtime Live or on my Facebook page or any other place that you might know me, like folk clubs around the place. Okay, well, that killed 2 minutes of my 4 minute allotted time, at least two. Now, we've got a fantastic week coming up this week. I'm not supposed to have like favorites and preferences, but I'll tell you, the three performers this week are just absolutely gobsmacking. Three professional performers. Carrie Martin on Wednesday, Pete Ivatz on Friday, but today, ladies and gentlemen, a consummate professional performer who has such charisma and style and personality. I feel like, although we're friends on Facebook, I feel like I know her. She just exudes that. Look at me, you must know me, because she is just such a lovely lady. And she's watching now, so I hope she's ready. Okay, I'm going to just hand you over in just a couple of minutes to the lovely Polly Morris, who will, I am absolutely certain, absolutely blow your mind. I know she's in the green room, which could be white or lilac or purple, but she's in the green room pacing. She's going to be all set up and prepared. And if you were in a club right now and somebody was to introduce Polly, this is what you'd get. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Polly Morris to the platform. The Village Stage, Lunchtime Live. They like you, Polly. They love you, Polly. Okay, everybody, stay indoors. No matter what the government says, stay indoors. Stay safe. See you soon.
Well, thank you. Now, one of the things that that you can do, just a little thing, is to donate, because the stage, the Village Stage, is raising money, and Jeff has just put some details on where you could donate after the show if you would like to. So do please read that, and do see if you can just give whatever you can to donate. Now, this next song is for Jeff, because during this time of lockdown, we have been really comforted by our pets. I mean, we've got a dog and a hamster, and they've been really comforting during this time, particularly walking the dog. So anyone who's got a pet is extremely blessed at this time. This is a song about, well, a slightly disappointing pet, actually. I just bought a bunny. I just could not resist. The only lop that was in the shop, as white as morning mist. He's the cutest thing you've ever seen. I'm so glad I could buy it. But now I'm home, don't want to moan, but is it meant to be this quiet? Dogs go woof, cats go meow, birds tweet and donkeys bray. But despite its clear intelligence, it has nothing to say. If you stand in a field of sheep, there's a right old caterwaul. My rabbit stamps its foot when cross. It's not the same at all. And I say, hello, little rabbit. And he says, I say, would you like a carrot? And he says, I say, are you glad I chose you? He says, I say, do you like your enclosure? And he says, he still says. We use the term to rabbit on, which means, I think, to chatter. It gave me the impression rabbits have some sort of patter. They'd comment on the food, the bed, the sawdust and their waiter. They'd say, don't feel like mating now, perhaps I'll do it later. He was quite expensive, he was all I could afford. And it's a con if I've got one who's got no vocal cords. He kicks and flicks and gambles, and he isn't being naughty. So maybe verbal feedback is just simply not his forte. I say, is silence just a habit? He says, I say, how do you talk to other rabbits? words, he says. I say, Beatrix Potter got it wrong, he says. I say, what was she on? And he says, he still says. He's such a personality, despite the lack of racket. Comes bustling when I'm rustling the rabbit treat packet. He hops about as rabbits should, oh yes, I can't dispute it. He chews my wires without causing fires or being electrocuted. I give him food and love and care and stroke his fur so white. To remain so mute when he's so cute seems rather impolite. But he's found a way of calling me if he wants me when I'm gone. He's worked out the remote control and turns the radio on. I say, I love your furry feet, he says. I say, you really are so sweet, and he says. I say, you're so cute and fluffy, he says. I say, I could have got a puppy, and he says, he still says, oh, he says, oh, he says, he still says. So that's ready.
I love that song, and Polly knows I love that song. In fact, I met Polly a couple of weeks ago. I was down in Dorset in my caravan, and I shot off to Wimborne on a Friday evening to see her in her regular little gig that she does at the Allendale Cafe in Wimborne. When she did one last night in lieu of lockdown, obviously she won't be able to do any more for a little while. So thank you, Polly. That was lovely. Here's another song, one of my favourites. I'm just hoping in these mad times that we're going through with so many issues in the world, that somebody is watching what goes on. Even if they're not interfering, somebody, some entity is watching from a distance. From a distance, the world looks blue and green, and the snow-capped mountains white. From a distance, the oceans meet the stream, and the eagle takes to flight. From a distance, there is harmony, and it echoes through the land. It's the voice of peace. It's the voice of every man. From a distance, we all have enough, and no one is in need. And there are no guns, no bombs, and no disease. From a distance, you look like my friend, even though we are at war. From a distance, I just cannot comprehend what all this fighting is for. From a distance, it's the love of love. It's watching us from the distance. I like that song. Yes, yes, Marilyn, I like that song as well. Thank you very much for your comments. And I hope if you're considering giving to the Just Giving platform there for Horsham District Food Bank, you'll consider that some of the things in that song even relate to the fact that we're not really doing that well. If you look from a distance, things are very different. Okay, I'm going to share another memory with you now. This one is from back in the 13th of July, and it was in fact my 50th presentation of Lunchtime Live during the summer. So I hope you enjoy. This is the best song, in my opinion. No, there are others, but this is one of the best songs that came out of Lockdown Live. Have a listen.
It's for you, Jeff, because we feel very honored to be here for your 50th anniversary. What a lineup you had. Did you hear all these names?
Fantastic.
Absolutely,
yes,
brilliant. So we're very, very honored to be lined up here for the 50th anniversary. And there's a little surprise. I have to dive down to my computer just to show you the little surprise for Jeff. Congratulations and celebrations.
Nice.
Congratulations, Village State, for the 50th anniversary show today. Well done, Jeff.
And so I think it works. It's called What If My Pockets Were Empty?
What if my pockets were empty? No more could I hold my head high. Could I still claim a seat at your table? Would I still be that glint in your eye? And what if the words that define me no longer be spoken with pride? What if my pockets were empty? Would I still have you here by my side? A cop that cries for mercy, or a glass that calls for wine? There but for good fortune, down that slippery road go I. Many words are spoken, too few deeds are done. For those whose lives are broken, and what their hopeless worlds become. What if my pockets were empty? No more could I hold my head high. Could I still claim a seat at your table? Would I still be that glint in your eye? What if the words that define me could no longer be spoken with pride? What if my pockets were empty? Would I still have you here by my side? Is it true what people say? We're all just a payday away. So come and walk beside me, past the doorways of our town, past the eyes that say, so why me? Why must I bear this cross and thorny crown? Your life changed tomorrow, your ship just turned around. Too proud to beg or borrow, too scared to face the cold, cold ground. What if my pockets were empty? No more could I hold my head high. Could I still claim a seat at your table? Would I still be that glint in your eye? And what if the words that define me could no longer be spoken with pride? What if my pockets were empty? Would I still have you here by my side? What if my pockets were empty?
Thank you.
I love that song so much, I actually did a cover of it. And I really enjoy singing it. I don't think it matches their skill and quality. However, if you want to see a good rendition of it, they also did one in their kitchen. I think it's on YouTube. That's Paul Walker and Karen Pfeiffer. And they did a rendition of that song in their kitchen. And out of all the times I've heard them play it, it is by far the nicest. It's beautifully done. Moving right along, because we must. That was a little expression that somebody who used to run a folk club would say. Moving along because we must. Here's a little song to fill in some time, a Charlie Lansbury song.
Moonlight on the water, casting its spell. Blind man, for the one thing my eyes cannot see. Darling, here I am in the night. Darling, how I'm missing you. The trees and the shadows are all dressed in. And the sky's not the only thing blue. It's been so long since I held you. Never known such a longing before. I can't eat and I can't sleep till my arms to hold you once more. Darling, how I look in the night. Darling, how I'm missing you. The trees and the shadows are all dressed in black, and the sky's not the old. How I'm missing you. The trees and the shadows are all dressed in black, and the sky is not the only thing blue. And the sky is not the only thing blue.
Bit of Charlie Lansbury there. Fill in some gaps. Okay. Now, we didn't only have, I was very, very lucky to have some really professional performers who do the circuit, make their entire living from music, and they're still struggling, but lots of them are doing their own live streams. But we also had some local performers of great talent. Some really good friends of mine came on, and I'm going to now share with you a clip from the very local and very entertaining Phil and Jane.
And work became impossible, but we've got Jeff, good old Just Jeff.
Yeah.
And not only has Jeff got us singing music here, he's also taught us how to use our phones.
Yeah.
So that's a big congratulations, Jeff, because I thought my days of relearning were definitely, definitely over. So there we are. But I do have to rely on Jane a fair bit and a daughter. So this song is called You'll Never Be the Sun.
You'll never be the sun. Thank you. You'll never be the song. Turning in the sky, and you won't be the moon above us on a moonlit night, and you won't be the stars in heaven, although they burn so bright. On the deepest ocean, you will be the light. You will be the light. You will be the light.
Thank you.
Oh my word, what a hauntingly beautiful song from a hauntingly beautiful couple. I was almost in tears. I really was. I don't cry very often. The last time I cried was when Rambo cut himself shaving, but that was really lovely. Okay, we're getting away with time now. I've got one more song and then a final memory and then a closing comment from me. This song is specifically for Christine. She always asks for it. Last night I dreamed you were back again, larger than life again, holding me tight again, kissing those same kisses on my brow, sweeter than ever now. Lord, I remember how. You're missing, no you don't, but I do. Days like a slow train trickle by, even the words I write refuse to fly. All I can hear is your song haunting me, can't get the melody out of my head. But I do, but I do. I wonder if I'm past the point of rescue. Is nowhere from you and all the best that you can do. Never meant to push yourself. Do you know how much I love you? No, I don't. But I do. I swore I'd never fall like this again. Fools like me never will come to my knees again. I close the door on the likelihood things might be just as good. Always believe they would. Don't let your love invite me. Maybe do you think it might be? No, you don't. But I do. But I do. I wonder if I'm past the point of rescue. There's nowhere from you and all the best that you can do. Never meant to push your shock in. Do you know how much I love you? No, you don't. But I do. But I do. I wonder if I'm past the point of rescue. There's nowhere from you and all the best that you can do. Never meant to push your shoulder. Do you know how much I love you? No, you don't. But I do. I know you don't. But I do. I know you don't. But I do. Is Christine there watching? Yeah, she goes, thanks, Jeff. Thanks. That's okay, Christine. That's just for you. Christine's been feeling a bit down through lockdown, so maybe that cheered you up. Okay, I don't have any more songs to do, but I'm going to make a comment at the end of this next section. Now, this next couple, I met them through another couple that were on, and they referred me to them, and they're absolutely delightful. And the song that I've chosen from Liz and Dave Wormsley is a song which reflects the occasion and the way we should all feel right at this moment. It's a very appropriate tune. And thank you, Liz and Dave Wormsley, for your performance back in... La, 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 la. When was it? Oh, I didn't write that one down. Never mind. It was some time back now. So enjoy this song, and then I will come back to close the morning off. Okay, enjoy.
So the best part of the day, thank you so much for listening.
Yeah, indeed. And thank you to Jeff as well for inviting us to do this. We've thoroughly enjoyed the preparation up to it, haven't we?
I can't say that it isn't nerve-wracking, I have to say.
It is pretty nerve-wracking.
But it's been lovely that we've been able to air our songs, and we'll look forward to reading all your comments. And thank you for listening. And like I say, we hope to see you on the road sometime, maybe next year. Yeah. That would be lovely.
Yeah, indeed. So, are we ready?
Yeah, you start this.
Oh, do I? Right, okay.
Diddly dee dee.
Yeah, well rehearsed, of course, as ever.
I turned that off while they were still talking. What a beautiful song. And what some beautiful performers I had during those months of lockdown last time through the summer. I get voices like Liz there and Jane's voice combined with Phil's. And lovely, lovely Karen Walker and Karen Pfeiffer and Paul Walker tunes, and Polly Morris doing her comedy stuff. I think we've been very, very lucky to have these people perform for us. Unfortunately, I'm not going to, well, I don't know about that, unfortunately, I'm not going to go to those lengths for this series. I have some guests over the next 3 weeks. Because of lockdown, they were going to perform here live, but two of them fortunately were able to get to me on Monday and Tuesday to pre-record their set. So next week, I have the fantastic instrumentalist, a brilliant guitarist, coming along, and he's going to do a half, about 25 minutes. I've split it into two. His name is Mick Wills, and next week, of course, is actual Remembrance Day on the 11th of November. So I will be adding to his performance with a few Remembrance Day songs of my favourite type, war songs, and probably another memory as well, because there's a particular song that I want to add into that session. So thank you for joining me today. Please consider at least contributing to a food bank or a worthy cause during these hard times that are coming up for this winter. And also, please tune in tomorrow to my own page. I won't be streaming it on this page. My own page, Jeff Yerrell, at Facebook. You can watch it. It's a public page. You don't have to be a member or a friend, or as long as you're not an enemy, you can join in. And I'll be doing this half an hour bike ride with just two or three songs along the way to make some money for Horsham Matters. Thank you for your entertaining company today. I can see there's been some lovely people on, and they're still sitting there. So thanks a million, and I'm going to sign off now. And I'll see you all next week. If not tomorrow, I'll see you all next week. Same time, same channel.